At Healthcare Partners Medical Group, our mission is to provide the highest quality of healthcare to each and every patient. With 5 locations in Pahrump, we are local doctors you know and trust. We want to thank you for choosing us. Quality care starts here.
In the last couple of years, Britain's royal family has been making headlines in the world of entertainment, with last year's royal wedding of Prince William and Kate Middleton, and this year's Diamond Jubilee to celebrate the 60-year reign of Queen Elizabeth II. The United Kingdom and many other parts of the world, including the U.S., have been celebrating the 86-year-old Queen's 60-year reign with the Diamond Jubilee celebration. Throughout the year, events have been taking place, but the main festivities took place over the course of 4 days. On Saturday, the Queen went to the Epsom Derby, which is a prestigious racing event with over 130,000 in attendance. Sunday was a Thames Diamond Jubilee pageant, which included the Queen herself, her husband Prince Philip, and her grandson and granddaughter-in-law, Prince William and Kate Middleton, traveling on the royal barge. Unfortunately, however, Prince Philip came down with a bladder infection and had to be hospitalized, missing the remainder of the celebrations. On Monday, the royals attended the Diamond Jubilee concert, which was shown here in the States. The Queen and her family enjoyed performances by Dame Shirley Bassey, Sir Elton John, Sir Paul McCartney, and many more. The Queen's son and next in line for the throne, Prince Charles, gave a heartfelt speech in honor of his mother. Tuesday, the final day of the festivities, began with a service at St. Paul's Cathedral, and following the service, they attended a reception. Following the final events of the festivities, Queen Elizabeth II rode back to Buckingham Palace by carriage, waving and smiling to the crowds of people who were in the streets to catch a glimpse of their long reigning monarch. Well, singer and songwriter Sheryl Crow has revealed that she has a brain tumor. Crow, who is a breast cancer survivor, stated that the tumor was discovered months ago after she saw a doctor due to experiencing memory loss. She did state that the tumor is not cancerous and will be monitored for any type of growth. The type of tumor Sheryl Crow has is called a meningioma, which is a common type. In fact, stars such as Elizabeth Taylor and Mary Tyler Moore had the same exact type. The singer's doctors have said that surgery is not required, but they will perform tests every couple of months to be sure it remains non-cancerous. Actor Penny Marshall, who you may remember as Laverne DeFazio from TV's Laverne and Shirley, is the victim of a scam. Marshall, a longtime LA Lakers fan, was reportedly scammed out of more than $5,000 after being tricked by someone who had claimed to be Laker player Lamar Odom's assistant. According to TMZ, it began last month when the supposed assistant began speaking to Marshall at a Lakers game. He subsequently gave her what he said was Lamar Odom's phone number. Over the next few days, the assistant posed as Odom through text messages and later asked her to loan his assistant $5,000. Those text messages stopped once she sent the cash. A report was filed with the LAPD and they have opened a grand theft investigation. I'm Zach Fuentes, and that was your entertainment this week.